In this segment of the word tutorial, we're going to learn how to insert and use shapes in a document in Word. Now, this function is not used as much, but at least for the sake of functionality of the product here, it will be worth covering. So we go here at any place on the document, then we click on the Insert tab, and then we go under Shapes. Now you can select any of those shapes. Of course, this is just to make a case. They have to be used purposefully for your document. And in this case, let's say I wanted to use one of those shapes. Now, one thing, unlike inserting a picture where the picture would be inserted automatically, or icons and other components in the document, here we have to draw how big or where we want this object to be inserted and how large. So we select it, and now at this stage, notice that the contextual tools show up. So it's tools related to the shape component. Now here we can apply various styles for this. We can apply various animations. And we can apply here the text wrapping to make it tight, and other components, and edit this. If you don't like this, you can change the shape from here using this tool, and it'll change it to something else, and so on. Now, one thing to keep in mind as you're working with the shapes, if, and this is just for the sake of learning about another thing here, is that if you go under Insert, you can actually, on top of this, you could insert a text box. So you could actually type stuff on top of this object. And you do that by clicking on Insert, choosing Text Box. And we are going to draw a text box directly as part of this. You can format this how you prefer. And then you can even change the background under the shape fill here to make it to no fill. And then you can make the text color, make it white, and in that way it fits the text a little bit better. So in this case, we are learning about two concepts. One, inserting the shape and adjusting it in the document. The other one was inserting a text box that we embedded on top of the shape. Now, sometimes in order to move these are two separate objects. And this is another concept. You can actually click on the text box, hold down the control key, click again on the larger one, the outside one. And if you right click, you can actually group those together. It moves as one object rather than two. And that's how you work with shapes and how you modify them.